this isn't even in tune, but this is what known as Dalek's handbag, because you can always take it and you can always exterminate people with it. My first job ever was in the summer holidays when I was in fifth form or something, and it was like adding up the marks at the City and Guilds exams, and my wage was £13 a week, and I was like, wow, I'm really in the money. It went mostly on comics, yeah, and then I was like, first I was a footballer's autographs hunter.
Yeah.
And then I'm, you cross the line, you know, like in the Alamo, they make a line and you go over, and then it was rock and roll from then on. I was always a big music fan, and I always wanted to be in a band. I'm all lost in the supermarket. But, something about collecting the autographs of the footballers stood me in good stead, you know what I mean? Because some of the footballers were really high and mighty and would look down.
Do you remember any?
Yeah, I don't want to mention any names, but I could. But anyway, but how they treated you stood me in good stead for how you may treat people later when you were in a position, the high and mighty position. You know, and then I used to follow Motley Hoople around, and they were most kind and generous to us. And then that was like, and I was like a really young guy, and I was like backstage when Mott played at the Albert Hall. I was like, I couldn't believe my luck, you know, to get. I used to stand outside Tramps and say the Stones were playing in London or something. I knew they would be going down to Tramps later. And I'd stand outside with my mates and I'd wait for them to come in, and it was like the Stones would come in and then Billy Preston just after. And then we would scoot in afterwards and we'd go, we're with them, and we would be in Tramps. You know what I mean? Like, as young, really young guys. Or I was in the speakeasy, one of the youngest guys in there. You know what I mean? I used to like bunk in and all that stuff. I started collecting comics, and then when I got a bit of money, I thought I would like collect Atom Age comics, right? It was like between Golden and Silver Age, right? And the thing that happens about those things is that it's like all about the time of the Korean War when it started, and it's like the Americans against Russians, you know what I mean? Coca-Cola against potato. And so it's very nice. And so I started, and so colourful. What I like in my exhibition is the colour. And the colour, it's like a flower arrangement with stuff, or a musical arrangement with stuff. So I kind of like the idea of it all being really almost gaudy.
So like
I like it to be really colourful and gaudy, so you get like a thrill. You know what I mean? But what happens with our exhibition is that people come in and they relate to it. They go on their own trip. And they go, oh, I had one of those, or I remember this, you know what I mean? And they go on their own trip. But it's not just a nostalgia trip. It is that originally, you know what I mean? But then you go on further. It's like something that just like proves who you are, really. And then we're realising it's a collective, as a collective thing. You know what I mean? It's not just my own madness. It's other people's madness as well. Oh, joined together. Nobody seemed to notice me. We had a hedge back home in the sun. What I would like to do with all my war books is put them into a library for everybody that they were able to share. My ultimate aim for what we're doing with the Rock and Roll Public Library is to actually, in this year, open a public library that people are going to go in use it for education and resource and go in and be able to take a book like a normal library. Because you know they're closing all the libraries, right, all around. So it'd be great. It'd be different to all your normal libraries, but I've got thousands of books and I'm happy to share them. I never could see.